Hello everyone. Today we are going to cover cost element accounting. These are the concepts which we are going to cover today. What are cost elements? What are different types of cost elements? Different types of cost element categories? Different ways of creating cost elements and tables where this data is saved? How to create cost element group and tables where this data is saved? How to display list of cost elements? So, what are cost elements? Cost elements are like GL accounts in FI. Cost elements are the basic master data with which the transactions are posted in CO module. Cost elements record and classify the consumption factors of an organization in controlling area. Cost elements record and classify. So, what are the types of cost elements? There are two types of cost elements: primary cost elements and secondary cost elements. Primary cost elements record the consumption of production factors whose source is external to the organization, whereas the secondary cost elements record the consumption of production factors whose source is internal to the organization. Let's go to our SAP system and see how these cost elements are created. There are different ways in which we can create our cost elements, like for primary cost element we can use transaction code KA01 for primary cost elements. In FS00 also there is an option to create primary cost element. We can create automatically using automatic creation of cost elements using transaction code OKB2 and OKB3. And secondary cost elements we can create in KA06. So primary cost elements are created in KA01 and secondary cost elements are created in KA06. For display and edit and delete purpose, the same transaction codes are applicable for both primary and secondary cost elements, KA02, KA03 and KA04, for both primary and secondary cost elements. For creation purpose only, the transaction code is different, KA01 for primary cost element creation and secondary cost element is created in KA06. Let's go to our SAP system and create cost elements. Also, for creating primary cost elements, we need to have already created the GL account in FI. We cannot create primary cost elements without having GL account created. Let's take one example. 4019 is the latest GL account. Let's create one more GL. Copy, click on copy. 4020. Click on OK. We are just creating the GL account. Enter text and click on save. So one way of creating primary cost element is by clicking this edit cost element button above. Let's click on this. Give valid from date. Click on OK. Cost element category 1. Click on save. So cost element has been created. So we have created cost element using transaction code FS00 by using edit cost element button. Create one more GL account 4021. Click on save. So 4021 GL account is created. Let's go to transaction code KA01 give over GL upon 4021, give valid from and valid to date, hit on enter, select cost element category 1 and click on save. So we have created cost element using KA01. Two ways we have tested. Let's go to OKB2 and see how the automatic creation of cost elements is done. First, let's create some GL accounts for testing purpose. Go to FS00. Select one GL account, click on copy, 4022. View text, click on save. Select one GL account, click on copy. Text. Click on save. Again, click on copy. Hit enter. Click on save. So we have created three GL accounts: 4022, 4023, 4024. So for these three GL accounts, we are going to create cost elements using OKB2. OKB2. So click on new entries, 4022 from 4024. Cost element category is 1. Three GL accounts. Click on save. Click on OK. Data saved. Go back. Go to OKB3. Select controlling area. Give valid from, valid to, session name, any name, and click on execute. So we can see three cost elements, 22, 23, 24. Category is 111. So these cost elements are created by processing batch input session, so and so, and controlling area is 2RCP. Valid from date is so and so. So a batch input session is successfully created. Now go to SM35. So here you can see that our batch input session is created. Status is created. Select this and click on process. Click on process. Controlling area, okay. Okay. Generally, this is executed in background. Since we are having only three GL accounts, I am executing in foreground only. So select our session name and click on log. So here we can see the session status as processed. Select this row and click on display. Here we can see that the transaction code KA01 is executed 3 times. This is nothing but a create cost element transaction KA01. So this is executed 3 times, processed successfully. Back. So we have successfully created a cost element using OKB2 and B3. Let's go to the table where this data, let's go to table CSKA and see the data is updated or not. SC16 CSKA chart of account to RCB. Select. We have created cost elements using FS00, KA01 and automatic creation of cost element using OKB2 and OKB3. 4020 to 4024. Click on execute. Here you can see that this one 4020 is the cost element which we created using FS00 and clicking on edit cost element. This 4021 we created using KA01 transaction. This 3 we created using OKB2 and OKB3. We have successfully created using 3 different methods. Now go to table CSKB XC16. CSKB, give controlling area to RCB, cost element 4020, 4024. Click on execute. Here, in CSKA and CSKB, the same data is available, but difference is that in CSKB, the data is saved at controlling area level, CO area, whereas in CSKA, data is saved at chart of account level. And also in CSKA we will not be having cost element category in any default account assignments. Like cost element category we can see in CSKB table. Also if we have any default account assignments like cost center, order, any default account assignments, we can see the data in CSKB. Also here we can see that there are different cost element categories, a list of cost element categories. Out of these, some belong to primary cost element, some belong to secondary cost elements. Cost element category 1, 11, 12 and 22 belong to primary cost elements. And cost element category 21, 31, 41, 42, 43, these belong to secondary cost elements. Let's go to KA06 and create a secondary cost element. KA06. For creating secondary cost element, we need not to have GL accounts. Anything we can give. This thing. Give from date to date. Any text. Here we need to select the cost element category. We cannot select one. Of course it is not available also. Let us select 43 internal activity allocation. Hit enter. Click on save. One more create. Category 42. Click on save. So we have created two secondary cost elements using transaction code KA06. Let's go back to CSKA table. Execute. At the bottom we can see our two secondary cost elements. Now let's go to cost element group creation. Transaction code is KAH1. Give name, hit enter. Testing group, hit enter and save. Here cost, different cost elements are grouped or combined to form a cost element group. Also the same cost element can be part of different cost element groups. So select this node and click on cost element. Select this drop down. Give your controlling area. Click on OK. Select our cost elements 4020 to 4024. Hit enter. So we can see the list of cost elements 20 to 24. Click on save. So our group is TESTING, testing, and it includes the following cost elements. This cost element groups are very much useful during report generation and the facilitated easy workflow. Like for example, during cost planning in T code KP06, we have this cost element from and to we can enter, or there is an option to directly enter this cost element group. For example, we show version 0 from to period here, cost center any, hit enter on display. Click on F4, your controlling area, click on OK. Here we selected our cost element group, which includes 40202 4024. So this screen will only allow the cost elements from 40202 4024. If we enter any other cost element, the system will not allow. Let's check by entering some other cost element. 4014 I am entering. Value 4014 is not allowed in the field cost elements. Why? Because in the KP06 main screen we selected our cost element group. So this cost element should be part of that group. What are the cost elements which are allowed? 40202 4024. Let's enter 4020. So it is allowing to show. Say. So KP01, we are able to restrict the cost element entry using this cost element group. Similarly, these cost elements groups are used while pulling reports. Like cost center actual planned report. Here also we are having option to enter either cost element group or individual cost elements. Like this, if you we can enter either this or this, both we cannot enter. So both we cannot. System says either a group or a value we can enter. Click on execute. So we planned 10,000 in KP06. Similarly, instead of entering individual cost element, we can select by cost element group, single entry we can say. Here we are having only 4 cost elements, but in real time scenario there might be hundreds of cost elements. We cannot enter individual individual cost elements. Select our cost element and execute. Same thing we will be getting. Go back. So we have successfully created our cost element group. So, testing. Now let's see in which table this data is getting saved. Go to table, set leaf. C16 set LEAF. Set class will be 0102. For cost element group. Cost element group. 0101 is for cost center group. Here we are looking for cost element group. So we will be selecting 0102. Okay. The organization unit is chart of account. 2RCP. Click on execute. This is the cost element group we created, and these are the cost elements from 4020 to 4024. So this is set leaf table. There is one more table, set node SC16 setnode. Set class will be 0102, organization 2RCB on execute. So here we can see our cost element group here under set ID. What does it mean? This is the part of one more group. This is the main group. This is a subgroup. We have created one more group, which is subgroup of this one. Subgroup of this one. Let's go to KAH3 display cost element group. Select main group. Enter. This is the group which we created. I created one more group above this group and linked this group to this group. So in set node table, what it shows, is that it shows this testing one group as a main group, as a set name. This group, it will show it as subset ID, set under a set. The transaction code KA23 is used to display all the cost elements in any controlling area. In KA23, go to extras, set controlling area, make sure that it is our controlling area. So we can select all cost elements and click on execute. So it will display all the cost elements, primary cost elements and secondary cost elements under this controlling area. Go back. We can select by group also. Click on OK. Select any group. Click on OK. Click on execute. So these are the cost elements under this cost element group. This transaction code KA23 is very much useful. We can select by cost element also, 4020 to 4024, and click on execute. So we can see the data relating to these cost elements under this controlling area. We can see cost element category, cost center, internal order, any data. With this, we have completed all the concepts which we want to cover today. Cost element creation, display. Okay, we have covered all the concepts today. Thank you.